Delivery of Medication via Nebulizers by Craig Smallwood.
Before we proceed, we'll also want to ensure that the patient is in the correct position. I'm going to put the head of the bed to approximately 30 to 45 degrees. An important performance note about jet nebulizers is that they should be oriented approximately vertically to work effectively. Tilting the device too far, perhaps 20 to 30 degrees on any angle, in any direction, can cause the medication to move away from the jet gas port inside the device and render the treatment ineffective. If you notice a treatment you are administering is taking a long period of time, or there doesn't appear to be an appropriate volume of aerosol generated, you may want to check the nebulizer to ensure proper vertical orientation. Next, I'm going to connect the nebulizer to our gas source using oxygen tubing. It should be noted that in order to adequately power jet nebulizers, a specific gas flow is required for this device. The manufacturer in this case recommends 9 liters per minute. However, it doesn't necessarily matter what type of gas. It could be 100% O2, air, heliox, etc. You'll need to exercise good clinical judgment to determine the appropriate gas for your treatment. Often, patients receive 100% oxygen if there are no contraindications, simply because this is the most readily available compressed gas in most institutions. But importantly, make sure that the gas flow is not running when you connect it. You should wait until the setup is complete and the device is adequately affixed to the child before you start the gas flow. This will minimize the amount of wasted drug and maximize the received dose. Next, I have our drug. I've removed the cap and I'm going to take our medication, which is in a liquid suspension, and place it inside the device. We're going to replace the cap, attach the interface, affix the oxygen tubing to the bottom portion of the nebulizer, and place the mask on our patient. I'm going to turn the oxygen flow rate onto 9 liters per minute as per recommendations by the manufacturer. This treatment should last anywhere from 10 to 20 minutes.